Hello, everybody. Welcome to Too Good To Be True podcast. I am your host, Pascal Mayala, a.k.a. Le Maréchal, a.k.a. Black Leopard, a.k.a. Black Fent. Before we go to the topic, I want to give my condolences to the people who died in the Kansas City Chief parade after the Kansas City Chief won the Super Bowl and had a parade after the victory and celebrated the Super Bowl, and we saw there was a shooting during the parade, and one person died and nine were hurt. The one who were hurt was children. And one of the person who died, it was a woman who was a DJ, and also she was a mother. God rest her soul. I feel bad for the child who would not witness her mother because she's not there anymore. And she's dead and cannot come back to life. But for the person who died, we send our condolences, and the people who got hurt during the parade. But thank God there were two juveniles was arrested and they would face the charges. So what I saw on Bleacher Report, they said that, I'll read a couple of one. Let's start with the woman who died, a couple of seconds I was talking about. Her name was Lisa Lopez Galvin, who was a 43-year-old mother of two and a radio DJ in Kansas City Chiefs area and a fan of the Kansas City Chiefs, was killed in a shooting by CNN reported, and that there was pretty much 22 injured. Everybody, 22 persons were injured during the parade. I mean, the United States need to find a situation with the gun law, and I'm not saying the gun law was Second Amendment that the people are allowed to have a gun. But I don't know the rule in United States with gun laws. I don't know which state allowed to have guns. I don't know about that, but the Republican and Democrat need to have a discussion with gun law, because the more we use gun law, the more people will die. And if the Republican and the Democrats don't get along and do not change the law, what will happen to the United States? What will happen to the people who just minding their own business and serve for no reason, shoot innocent people for no reason at all? I mean, when are we going to make a change? I don't mind when people have gun, because gun is not just a toy. Gun is just to protect your family and other stuff too. But using a gun to shooting people, especially innocent people, for no reason, is pretty much idiotic. I mean, very idiotic. Especially in a parade that you celebrate a championship in the city, in your own city. Does every city have to have a gun every time we have to celebrate and you have to kill people? I mean, the United States have to change something. The United States need to change some law. Because I'm sick and tired when we say our condolences are to the person who died. Because we always said that, then we move on. No, I want some change. Change is very necessary. I mean, change is very important. They need to change the law for people are using gun. People need to stop using gun as a toy. Especially when you win, when you celebrate a team that won a championship. It is going to be every time every year that a team win a championship. And we have to see gun violence and killing innocent people. Because I'm sick and tired of people don't know how to behave. If the Republican and the Democrat do not make a change. I mean, I don't know. What's going to happen in the near 10 or 15 years after this? You're going to kill random people for no reason. And who's the person who lost? The innocent one. And the bad guy, move on in his life. You know what I'm comparing this, like a shooting? A drunk driver got no business to be in a wheel on a car. And when he drives the car and he's sober and doesn't know how to control the wheel, and he turned left or right and have an accident, the one who got hit in an accident by the car dies, and the one in the wheel live. I mean, I'm sick and tired of this BS. When the government of the United States make a change, when the government try to change the law for people who are using gun. Now a mother of two died, and the two kids who was in the parade not going to see their mom again. I don't know what they're going to do, to be honest with you. But my condolences to the mother, the 43-year-old the mother who was the DJ. And the people who were hurt, I think they need to change the way they win championship for the parade. That's all I'm going to say about that subject. Now, let's get some news topic of in every sport. So let's start with the NFL. So Jimmy Garoppolo has been suspended for 2 games. According to Adam Schefter. So, So what is it about with the Jimmy Garoppolo suspension? So they say that the quarterback, the Las Vegas quarterback Jimmy Garoppolo, will miss the first two games of the 2024 season after being suspended by the NFL for violating a policy on performing enhanced drugs. Man, according to Adam Schefter, so what it means that Jimmy Garoppolo has been using PED policy that the NFL PED that the NFL not allowed players to do or players to use. I might add, I will say this. I do agree with the NFL because what happened if Jimmy Garoppolo died? Because some of those PEDs we have to use are not prescribed in the medication. And to me, I think it was a great thing what they're doing. And to me, it shows that the policy is legit. And if you use like the weed or the marijuana, and you're playing, and you get tested, the NFL have the right to suspend you. The NFL has the right to tell the GM or anybody in the organization that player is suspended. But there also the flip side of it, we have to look at the player perspective of Jimmy Garoppolo. Did he use PED? Did he know what it will cost him a suspension not to play in the 2024 season? So to me, Jimmy Garoppolo should have been aware of it. I don't know about the full detail, but I'm looking at the Bleacher Report. That what Adam Schefter said. So he did say that they said that he used a performance enhancing substance policy, which he violated the NFL, which you're not allowed to do it. You're not allowed to use PED. That's according to Adam Schefter. But also, another news came out from the NFL, which is involved Jimmy Garoppolo again. And people say, oh, again, what is it about? Is about Jimmy Garoppolo will be expected to be released from the Las Vegas Raiders after the PED suspension. So that means in this offseason, he will be released and he's in a free agency now because I think, if I'm not mistaken, Jimmy Garoppolo, they said that He will be cut and he will earn $11 million from a roster bonus in March. That means he will get the $11 million plus the bonus Because remember, Jimmy Garoppolo signed a $72 million during the offseason of the 2023 when Josh McDaniel was the head coach and Dave Ziegler was the manager. Remember, during the free agency. Since that time, both of them, with Josh McDaniel and Dave Ziegler, has been fired. The Raiders are pretty in a good position right now. After those two personnel got fired, Antonio Pierce was the interim coach. And then in week 8 against the Lions, when during the time the Lions beats the Raiders, Jimmy Garoppolo was benched. And he was replaced by Aidan O'Connell. Thank God. I remember his name. For the rest of the season. Now, to me, now that Jimmy Garoppolo has been released, what will the Raiders do during the offseason? Should they sign a free agency QB like Justin Fields or Russell Wilson or Kirk Cousins? Actually, there's three. This one's the number one. Number two, they go to the draft. They draft one of those young QB, because that young QB to the draft Oh, my bad. Sorry. And my final option is Aidan O'Connell is the QB of the Raiders. When I said that, I said they keep him and he's the future of the Raiders QB. That's the three choices they have. So if I'm Mark Davis and I'm sitting in my office and I have to choose those three options, and you telling me what should I do with the QB situation, should I keep Aidan O'Connell and be the main number one QB? Should I draft the QB? Or should I sign another QB from free agency, like I said? Like Justin Field, Russell Wilson, and Kirk Cousins, so on and so forth. I'll do this. I'll put a gamble on free agency to look around which QB that I want. If none of those QBs that I want are not available, I will go to the draft, look in those prospect QB who may not have the radar, not even in the radar, my bad, but he could be the future. Or I do this. I keep Aidan O'Connell and become the QB for the Raiders. That's all the three choices that Mark Davis have to think. That's all I got to say about that, people. It's up to Mark Jackson to decide. Other news in the NBA is that the All-Star is here. The All-Star is here. And I gotta tell you, this rookie showdown is gonna be very interesting right now. It's gonna be very interesting to see the rookie showdown this Friday. And the celebrity all-star that I'm watching now, unfortunately you can't see it because I don't have a video yet, are starting now. And Saturday will be like the three-point shootout, the dunk contest, so on and so forth. And Sunday, the NBA All-Star, which I'm going to make that second fiddle. But I'm so hyped to see the All-Star game. Because the last time I saw the All-Star, it was terrible. The NBA All-Star in Utah was terrible. It probably the worst NBA All-Star I ever seen in my life. It's up there with the 2017. It's probably up there with the other than those two, I don't see a terrible game, All-Star game. They have been competitive all those years. So, and thank God they got rid of the captain and the draft. Because that was also terrible. I'm going to admit that. That was very, very terrible. But also, I got another news to add up. The NBA finalists for the 2024 Basketball Hall of Fame. So, who is in the finalists we're talking about? So the finalists, if not confirmed who's getting in, so I will introduce the finalists. Vince Carter, Chauncey Billup, Michael Cooper, Walter Davis, Simone Augustus, Dick Barnett, and Michelle Timms. And there's other former finalists like Bob Ryan, Charles Smith, Marianne Washington, Harley Redding, Doug Collin, Herb Simmons, and Jerry West as a former coach and executive among the finalists. Who do you think I see getting in the Hall of Fame? I'm going to tell you, Vince Carter is automatically, Chauncey Billups, Michael Cooper will be in, and you need a WNBA, so I'll get Simone Augustus who will be in. I don't know how many players should get in the Hall of Fame, because I don't know what's the number. But if imagine it's seven, so I said Vince, Chauncey Billups, maybe Michael Cooper. I will put questionable Michael Cooper. Questionable Michael Cooper. But I will put Simone Augustus gonna be in it. Dick Barnett, Jerry West as executive. My bad. Who else? Doug Collin will be in. And my finalist, you know what? I'll put Walter Davis. Those are my seven people to get in the Hall of Fame. That's all I gotta say about that. Now, I want to talk about something, but before I talk about it, let's take a break, then I'll be back. Now, welcome back, welcome back, welcome back. So, now let's talk about the NFL offseason. But before we talk about that, I want you to say that during the killing of the shooting and parade in Kansas City, there was a lot of athletes who came to the hospital to see little children who has been wounded, not in a sense of a hurt of blood, in a sense of who were pretty much injured. Those people who were in the hospital, and the athlete, actually players from the Kansas City Chiefs, came to visit those people. And there's another news that Taylor Swift has donated $100K to the family who was killed at the Chiefs parade. And I would say this, say what you want about Taylor Swift. And she is, like I said, moving the needle. And she is dating Travis Kelce. And that she won Grammys. Don't forget that she's a human being. And she's very generous as a person. And that was very kind of her to do that. And I would say this, kudos to Taylor Swift. Now, let's talk about the NFL offseason. Because, yes, NFL is over. But, the offseason is on. And a couple of weeks it will be the NFL Combine. Then in March, I believe March. Will be March or April will be the NFL draft, so on and so forth. And baseball is starting. But I will talk about a little bit about my Blue Jays. Yes, for those people who don't know, I am a Blue Jays fan. Very proud of. But I do wear a Yankees hat. So who do I think will be in the offseason and who need to be traded or rumors? So let's start with the QB. We talked about the QB actually, a little bit when we talk about the Jimmy Garoppolo stuff. But who else do I see getting traded or staying or get the bag? So, let's start with Brandon Ayuk, who just recently went to the Super Bowl. Where do I see him playing? Maybe not next year, because he still have one contract left, one year deal left in his contract. Where do I see him play? And according to Bleacher Report, there's six possibility. I think there's six possibility team that he can go. So, to me, let's start with what Bleacher Report said. Bleacher Report said that there's six possibility, but before that, let's say what his girlfriend said. Her girlfriend said that Brandon his girlfriend said that. So if you don't know who's Brandon Ayuk's girlfriend, her name is Rochelle Seawright, if I'm not mistaken. Rochelle Seawright. She went live on her Instagram that she think that that it's probably time to see Brandon Ayuk play for another team if the 49er doesn't pay in March the money that he asked. So which six team did I see? Number one, Arizona Cardinal. Number two, Houston Texan. Number three, Jacksonville Jaguars. Number four, Kansas City Chiefs, who recently won the Super Bowl. Number five, the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. And number six, the Washington Commanders. Okay, let's start with the Arizona Cardinals. Let's start with them, number one. Let's start with them. This is my I don't need to read the what Bleacher Report said. This is my opinion, and it comes from me. I do not see Brandon Ayuk playing for the Kansas City Chiefs, but I will talk about them later. So Arizona Cardinals, I don't see, because they are in a rebuild. So I don't know what's going to happen with Arizona. But they need to draft. They need another wide receiver, another running back, an offensive lineman, probably a defensive lineman. They need everything, okay? That's my opinion. So number two, Houston Texans. They're a young team. I do see them. They're a young team. I don't think they can fit, but I do see veteranism in this team, because they need somebody to held accountable. So I do see them fit with the Texans, especially CJ Stroud, who, by the way, had a phenomenal rookie year. And they need to bounce from actually leaping from good to great and to be a contender. So I don't think it's not bad. That's not a bad place to play. Number three, Jacksonville Jaguar, who, by the way, they almost made the playoff. I do see it, but really, I don't know. I love Trevor Lawrence. I do like Etienne Jr. and the rest of the crew. I don't know. I have to really rethink about it for him. The Kansas City Chiefs, I said, why you want to go to a beat that beat you? I mean, I don't see it. I don't. That's a bad idea. Don't go there. To be honest with you, don't go to the Kansas City Chiefs. Bad idea. Don't go to the team that beat you, and don't do like a Kevin Durant thing. So, yeah, don't do like a Kevin Durant, please, Brandon Ayuk. Don't do it. Tampa Bay Buccaneers. I do see it. I do see him in the Buccaneers. It depends on Mike Evans. It depends on Mike Evans. If he want to stay, he want to go. If he stays, I think they could win the NFC South. If Mike Evans stay. If he's not, but what's the point? But I do see him in the Buccaneers jersey. I do see it. And finally, Washington Commanders. For them, it will depend. It will depend on two things. Number one, if they draft Caleb Williams, or actually, if they draft a QB, maybe Caleb Williams, it will be there. If they draft. Number two, if they are in a rebuild, which I think they are in the rebuild. They are in a rebuild. If they draft a quarterback, if they draft a young QB, maybe Caleb Williams, I don't know. If they do, I think he will go. If he doesn't, I don't think he will go. So, like I said, Buccaneers, I do see it. Jacksonville is questionable. Houston, Texas, I think it makes sense. Arizona, they're on the rebuild. Kansas City, don't do it. And Washington, it will depend. Or you could do another one thing. Stay with the greenest grass. That's for Brandon Ayuk. I'm mad. Now, for Davante Adams. Because I see Davante Adams is a free agent. Where do I see Davante Adams go? So, where do I see Davante Adams will go? Maybe rumor saying that it's not me. I didn't spoil the rumor. I think some people said it. If Davante Adams will leave, could it possibly? And I mean possibly join the New York Jet, reunite with Aaron Rodgers, get that one more magic. Could it happen? I don't know. Could Devontae Adams stay in Las Vegas? Because, you know, he was happy when Josh McDaniels left. And Antonio Pierce are doing a phenomenal job. And I think the Raiders have a good direction. And now, yeah, like I said, yeah. Antonio Pierce is the head coach of the Raiders right now. And the Raiders is much way up. For another topic, a free agency player, Russell Wilson. Where do you think he will land? There's three teams I can see. The Falcons. The Steelers, or maybe the Giants. Where do I think he will go? Atlanta, it will depend. New York, the big market. I said Atlanta. Giant or Washington Commanders, if he's available, or what the Washington Commander will do, they'll draft, I don't know. It will depend on what Russell Wilson wants. For another QB who's in the free agency, Justin Field, where he's gonna go if he stay with the Bears, if he gone from the Bears, because remember the Bears have the number one draft pick in the first round. Who do you think they're gonna get? Who do you think they're going to get in the draft? Caleb Williams? A wide receiver? I don't know. If the Bears keep Justin Field, because we've seen the progress this 2023 season, even though they went to a rocky couple game, but we're seeing the progress of Justin Field. Do you think he will stay in Chicago? Maybe not. Do you think I see him playing for the Falcons? I do see it. It's a perfect marriage. Or he's been one of those big markets like New York, who desperately need a QB. I don't know. What about Kirk Cousins? Do you think he will stay with the Vikings? I think so. If he get the pay cut, yes. If you get the pay cut, absolutely. I think Kirk Cousins will stay with the Vikings. So this is what the first half of the free agency. Now let's talk about. I didn't have a chance to talk about this. I just want to do a brief couple of minutes. Then I will talk about the MLB. So, the 49ers have fired defensive coordinator Steve Wilks. I think we all saw that. My thinking is, why Kalshan you did that? What did you do that for? I mean, they cannot even stay in one, in more than 1 year to develop. I mean, why Kalshan did that? Maybe he's afraid that he will be part, he will be the blame. If it is that, I got news for you, Kyle Shanahan. You are the problem. Yes, Steve Wilk did not do a good job, but to fire him for that is inexcusable. I mean, you fire Mo Salah. You fired D'Amico Ryan, who both of them are head coach. And now you fired Steve Wilks, which is very unfair. That's all I got to say about that. Now, I want to talk about the MLB right now. MLB. The season will start. Now we're pretty much at the start. They're still in training camp. The other team, every team are in a training camp. What do I expect for What do I think about? Actually, I'll take it back. It's my apologize. What do I expect this season for my Blue Jays? I expect to have a success season like last season, which this regular season they were good. In the playoff, I mean, my God. I mean, they got swept by the Minnesota Twins. It's inexcusable. Right now, they need to go back to the lab and be better. Now, what do I think about Shohei Ohtani playing for the Dodgers? I expect big time. Do I think they're the favorite to win the World Series? I don't know, because they're a good team. There's a good team. That will be good. The New York Yankees. Are they going to get a postseason success? Are they going to make the playoff? Same thing for the Mets. Are they going to get over the hump? And what about the Texas Rangers? Are they going to repeat? Are they going to repeat to win, go back to the World Series? That's the question I will ask. Now, we do have 11 minutes. So let's talk about the women college basketball. And I will say this, congratulations to Caitlin Clark, who surpassed Kelsey Plum for the all-time scoring list. I mean, I will say this. This woman is special. I don't care. And she's box office. And she is. And she is box office. If the WNBA, I almost say WWE, but if the WNBA gets a player like an Injuries or a Juju Watson, or especially Kenny Clark, or Paige Bucker, I believe Paige Bucker. I forgot her name, but if they pick those players, especially her, Caitlin Clark. Can you imagine the revenue of the WNBA? Well, what would happen? Yes, my bad. Paige Buchers. I apologize. Paige Buchers. Do you know how many people are gonna watch the WNBA? And I support the woman basketball, and not, the woman basketball should go up. And I think Caitlin Clark is good for the WNBA. And I mean, she is special. And I think that the NBA will be a better place for casual fan and fan watch the WNBA if Caitlin Clark decide to go to the WNBA. So we do have eight minutes left in the podcast. Since we are talking about culture, I really want to talk about sneakers. Let me talk. And I saw something Air Jordan dropped, I believe. I see one of those release. This release of Jordan, I believe it was Jordan 1, I saw Jordan 1 retro high 85 OG metallic burgundy. I must say it's not bad, even though I'm not really an Air Jordan 1 with all white, because it's kind of weird, it's not my stuff. But I got them, it's pretty clean. If you want to buy it, go buy it. And another sneaker that I was interested in, and actually there's two sneakers that I like. Number one is the return of the Nike Zoom KD All-Star Galaxy, who I think Kevin Durant wore during the 2012 All-Star. I remember that. Remember, because we were playing Orlando. I thought it was pretty good. I think it's a cool sneaker. I think I will hoop on it if I have it. And another sneaker release is the Kobe 8 Pro Troll color purple. And I'm gonna admit, I'm not gonna say I like it, I dislike it, or I like it. I am in the middle. I think it's an okay shoe. Do I think I'm gonna wear it to play hoop? No, I will not. But it's a pretty dope sneaker. Now, if you had to tell me, because we got 5 minutes, what is my top 5 Air Jordan sneakers? If you were to ask me right now, my top 5 favorite sneakers is, if not a particular order, so I got the Jordan 4, they're my favorite, Jordan 3, Jordan 11, Jordan 1s, and Jordan 12. Those are my top 5 favorite sneakers. What is my top 5 sneaker to hoop on, if you ask me? My top five sneaker to hoop on, well, Kobe's. I got a Kobe Grinch. I'll say LeBron 15. I will say Kobe 6. I believe Kobe 6. Kobe 6. And I wear from KD too. KD, I believe KD 14 or 15. I believe. But check on it, people. And my last. I say Kobe 6 Grinch. LeBron 15. Kobe 6. Actually, I say Kobe 6, but let's say this. I would place with Kobe 6, but Kobe 5. I would place Kobe 6 by Kyrie. That will make like 3. KD. My final is. You know what? Kyrie, when he was with Nike. So that's it for the show today, and before I leave, I just want to apologize for my Instagram account. So when I say Pascal slash. Mayara slash 15. Actually, I meant it was Pascal underscore Mayara underscore 15. So I will apologize for that. Now, if you want to follow me on Twitter or at Facebook and Twitter. So for my Twitter, it is Belly versus Mayala versus PMM. My bad, sorry. Belly versus PMM. So Twitter is Pascal underscore Mayala underscore 15. On Threads is the same thing. Pascal underscore Mayala underscore 15. Facebook is Pascal Mayala. And if you want to listen to the other podcast, the previous podcast, you can follow me, my previous podcast, Too Good to Be True podcast, and only on Spotify. So I hope everybody enjoyed my today podcast, and I will say this: see you next time.